Hi, let's create Zephyr OS apps with device drivers using example application. Let's get started. In the last episode, I said next project will be real application, but I would like to tell more about creating workspace apps and freestanding apps, which involves drivers. I will share some tips and tricks because we will need them when we dive into real application. Most of the tips and tricks in this episode may also be used for other boards. Just by the way, I am assuming you have watched the previous episodes. I will talk about the following subjects respectively. Mainly, there are three application types, but today I will focus on workspace apps and freestanding apps. Applications inside the workspace folder are called workspace applications. The Zephyr OS and modules are included in the workspace. With this, we can version control Zephyr OS, Zephyr modules, and our own modules. Applications outside the workspace folder are called freestanding applications. They don't contain Zephyr OS or Zephyr modules. Instead, they are linked to the other workspaces like this one using environment variables. With this, we can put the application wherever we want, without including Zephyr OS or Zephyr modules. In the last episode, I didn't explain why I choose freestanding application. Later on, I will explain when to use which type, and I will give some tips and tricks to increase your productivity and save some time. How to set up example application as workspace application. I will use the example application published by the Zephyr project. This project includes a sample of custom board, driver, and application in all-in-one package. When we set up workspace applications, we need two commands. Vest init creates a workspace. Vest update downloads the required modules for the workspace defined in the manifest file. First, let me explain the arguments of the vest init. M passes the manifest file repo URL. MR passes the manifest file revision. This could be branch, tag, or SHA of commit. The last option is the workspace directory name. I will create the workspace, but please don't try right now. Wait for the tweaks. This is the folder structure of my workspace folder. Let's add Raspberry Pico board. Copy Nucleo overlay file and rename to RPI Pico. Open new overlay file and change GPIOC to GPIO0. Let's try to compile example application. Build test for Raspberry Pi Pico board. Build test for Nucleo board. Initializing workspace with local manifest files. If you have already cloned the example application or made some changes like me, how do you initialize the workspace? All we have to do is tell Vest where to find manifest file. In this case, it will be the local path of the Vest YAML. Let me test it for you by creating second workspace. Delete build folder of example application. Create a new folder for workspace. Copy the example application inside the workspace folder. Use vestinit-l to initialize the workspace. Then run Vest update. Build test for Raspberry Pi Pico board. Workspace application tips and tricks. Reducing Git transactions. When running Vest update, you might have seen tags in Git log. Actually, in most cases, we can skip that part using the narrow option. This may save us some time as it will reduce Git transactions. I already checked elapsed time of Vest update with and without narrow option, and here are the results. However, if you have already removed unused modules, this may not make a big difference, as there are few modules left. Removing unused modules. When we create workspace with Vest, it will clone all modules regardless you need them or not. Let's check the modules/hal folder inside our workspace. For example, if you are working with Raspberry Pi Pico, typically you only need RPI Pico and SimSys modules. Let's check how much space we can save by excluding other modules. It is 3.1 GB. So how do we include the modules only we need? First, we will initialize the workspace with local manifest file as I described before. Delete build folder of example application. Create a new folder for Workspace. Copy the example application inside the Workspace folder. Use vs.init-l to initialize the workspace. Open the manifest file. Change import yes to import. Add name hello list after import line. And after that, add all the modules you need. I already modified the manifest file for the Raspberry Pi Pico and Nucleo board. You can access them from here. So how do we know which module we need? Please follow these steps for your SoCs. For more about manifest files, please check the docs. Let's check how much time we can save with this. And here are the results. Let's try to compile example application. Selecting between Zephyr OS repos. Let's say you are developing some drivers for Zephyr OS and you need your own fork. Let me show you how to select between repos. Open the manifest file. Remove the remote line. Add your own repo. Add defaults to choose which remote repo will be used. Let's check the result with VEST update. Now, let's switch to the other repo. Let's check the result with VEST update. VS Code setup for workspace applications. If you are using Raspberry Pi Pico and wanted to use in-circuit debugging feature as I explained in the last episode, you can get required VS Code settings from here. Let's clone the repo. Copy .vs code folder into example application folder. Open example application folder on VS Code. Then open the terminal on VS Code and compile. How to set up example application as freestanding application. In the last episode, I talked about freestanding apps, but in that example, there was no module driver involved. When we use the freestanding application type, Zephyr OS and modules in the linked workspace will be used, and none will be downloaded. Let's create the freestanding app. Copy the example application anywhere you want. Run the Zephyr environment script temporarily. Build test for Raspberry Pi Pico board. Build test for Nucleo board. VS Code setup for freestanding applications. When using freestanding applications, we need to tell Zephyr build system where to find Zephyr OS, modules, and external modules. We will set those in VS Code settings. You can get required VS Code settings from here. Copy .vs code folder into example application folder. Open example application folder on VS Code. Then open the terminal on VS Code and compile. Where or when to use each one. Structure of example application and the device driver. The app folder is your application directory. The boards folder is used for custom boards. Custom plank board demonstrates how to create custom boards. If you don't need custom boards, you can delete the boards folder. The zephyr/module.yaml file will be used to determine which files should be added to the build. Modules contain CMakelists and Kconfig files describing how to build and configure them respectively. The CMake part specifies the path to the module's CMake entry point. In this case, this file will be included by Zephyr build system. The Kconfig part specifies the path to the module's Kconfig entry point. In this case, this file will be sourced into Zephyr Kconfig tree. The board root part specifies that directory contains boards folder to use. In this case, this folder will be included by Zephyr build system. The DTS root part specifies that directory contains DTS binding files to use. In this case, this folder will be included by Zephyr build system. The DTS folder is used for DTS binding files. These are used for device drivers. This file is the CMake entry point of the module and tells Zephyr build system to include drivers folder using CMake's add subdirectory command. This file is Kconfig entry point of the module and tells Zephyr Kconfig tree to source drivers/kconfig file using relative source command. The drivers folder pointed by the Kconfig and CMakelists files is used for the drivers in this example. The drivers folder name can be anything, as long as it matches the definition in the Kconfig and CMakelists files. Let's take a quick look to the source code. The example application uses sensor API. Mainly, there are three parts: get the device instance, fetch the sample, and get the sensor value. This line gets the device instance. Example sensor 0 is defined in the board overlay file, and this is how hardware components pass to the driver. Let's take a look at the driver. All we have to do is fill these three functions. This is how driver functions are linked to the sensor API. You can find sensor header file inside Zephyr OS folder. By the way, all drivers in this folder use the sensor API. I know it's been a while. I had to take a break because I had some health issues. I got better now and I'm looking forward to making new videos. In the next episode, I will talk about real application with Zephyr OS. Please check the video description for codes, links, etc. I hope you find this video interesting. Please let me know what you think in comments. Please consider like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button. Thanks for watching.